So as Bendel said, the topic for today is business intelligence. I want to quickly review what business intelligence is, what the value and what is the value that business intelligence offering, and quickly review the BI evolution. Before all this, I want to introduce a few terms that we use day-to-day basis, I'm sure we all know. First is data. The data is the raw value of elements. After we collect the data and organize it, it will have some meaning. That meaning that the data provides is called information. After that, the concept of understanding information and performing some analytics on that, we get some insight out of the information that is called knowledge. That knowledge can be the base for decision support systems that is the end goal for BI. As the top chart shows, the data is the foundation. The data is mostly collected by the transactional processing systems, and then analytical processing takes the information and the knowledge out of the data. Again, to review what transactional processing is and what analytical processing is, transactional processing, as it's indicating from the name, focuses on each transaction that is happening on each row of data, like insert, update, delete. But analytical processing focuses on reporting analytics, which is used for decision support, and it's going to be the source for data mining. And to further explain what transactional system or OLTP or and what OLAP is, the example we have in the operational applications that we use every day-to-day basis to run our tasks in our companies, we use the applications. All those applications have their own specific database. That databases, each database is focused on a business process, and the questions that that database can answer is only focused to a subject area, like product, advertising, and customer. But they are all collected and organized and transloaded to data warehouse, which is an integrated database that serves for analytics. When it's in data warehouse, then it can answer cross-subject questions. Like, for example, what kind of advertising I can do on which product for which type of customers to increase my sale this year. Now, if we want to define the business intelligence is for all the methods and processes that makes all this possible, makes us gather the data and transform it into information. Then run some analytics on the information and get the insight out of it to be used for our decision making. Business intelligence uses historical data to do all this to get to the new information. The data that is loaded to data warehouse can be from all type of data, structured, non-structured, from different type of data sources, and no matter how complex the data is, it can be loaded into data warehouse. And the problems that business intelligence developer face is that sometimes the data is not available. Sometimes people just do perform their work without any data to be in anywhere. They just know how to do their work. So sometimes the data is not accessible, or accessing it is costly. Sometimes it's spread everywhere. Integrating them is costly as well and complicated. Sometimes there are technical issues or administrative issues to access the data. To define a business intelligence process, the process has five major steps. Like I said, it's collecting the data, cleaning and transforming the data to make them integrated into one data warehouse, the third step is loading the data into the data warehouse. Fourth step is data analysis. Here is, this is the step that information and knowledge is extracted from the data from the previous three steps. This is the step that some multidimensional analysis or statistical analysis are performed on the data to get the information and the knowledge. Information and the knowledge that is the result of this fourth step is being used for data presentation last step to create some reports and dashboards to provide, to be used by decision makers to be the, to support their fact-based decisions. So the end product of the BI process is to support the decision, the decisions. That's why if we look at from decision-making point of view, this is the BI process, to collect the data, organize it, and get the insight out of it, make decision, and take action for that decision. Business intelligence and data warehouse started in 1990s. After that, in 2000, different reports and dashboards were built to present the data warehouse. And in after 2000 was the time that big data and data science concept rise because of the maturity of hardware and software. Especially hardware became cheaper. That's what it made us, it enabled us to store big data and analyze it. So the value that BI offers is that the, it's a single platform at enterprise level that is that has integrated data, and it's a single source of the truth. The way it's been designed, it's easy and fast to get the data, and it's used for decision support. This is the architecture for Microsoft BI stack. The data on the left is the data in different format from files, from SharePoint, from cloud, on-premises databases. Is loaded to data warehouse. After that, BI developers create either multidimensional cubes or tabular models for the analytics. These are built based on top of the aggregated data. And then we have either BI developers to create reports and dashboards using SSRS or Power BI. Or we have Power BI, or we have Power users to directly connect to the cubes and to the models to do their own analysis. So again, the data management that is happening here, operational databases, focus on transaction. They are not good for complex analysis, and they usually don't hold that much of data. They usually have 6 months, 2 years. More than that, they are quite the rest. But data warehouse is designed to hold the historical data. That the purpose is to have low write, high read. That's why it's fast and easy to query and get the data. And it's coming from multiple different type of sources. To get from operational databases to data warehouse, it's ETL, extract, transform, load, the three first steps that I mentioned before. I guess I passed one, but the analysis tools that is used is either reports, canned report, ad hoc report, or OLAP. OLAP is based on, with high volume, is based on the aggregated data, or it can be business analytics, which is to explore the data and to run what-if scenario analysis and do some projection. This is the type of report between the difference between the OLTP reports that OLTP systems provide or versus the bottom chart that has OLAP reports. The top one is simple, subject specific. The bottom one is from a BI report that has cross subject. You can drill down from each cell of this table and get to more granular different subject that makes this number. This is the difference between report and dashboards. Dashboards are very high level, mostly high level managers. When they come, they just want to know how they are performing. They just want to drill down to see where they are not doing so well and why, how can they make it better. Different type of BI users. Again, IT developers are to extract information and knowledge from data, and then after that, we have super users, analysts, and statisticians to use the data warehouse and the models and the cubes for their own benefit. Business intelligence is all about getting the right information to the right people who are the decision making at the right time. It's an integrated single platform enterprise level, and it supports decision, data-driven decision making, and it's using historical data for that. The vision is to improve organizations to support their decisions.
That's all. Thank you.